Does that sound okay? I have two webcams with the same name, and I also did an upgrade on my computer, so it turns my sound off every time. That sounds okay? All right. I have one webcam here and one webcam over here, and it's external now. And I like this one better than that one. So as long as I don't sound echoey, I'm going to be on this one. They're exactly the same, except the one's names itself number one and number two, depends on which plug I put it in. It's a whole production. So, yay, I'm glad you guys can hear me okay. So, I was just saying, yes, we are going to be out of state company too. Carol, I'm glad you're back. Thanks for checking in, everybody. Good morning, Feline, Eastern Oregon. My brother lives in Western Oregon, I guess. He's in Coos Bay. Both of my brothers and my sister, actually, they're all in Coos Bay. And then my daughter's in Eugene. So it's been a busy week. My husband put some shelves up in my room. I'll take some pictures and post them next time. Well, when I return. Hi, Mary. And so I try to do the. Oh, it's beautiful there. I try to do the drawing with the name picker thing because I have a program that does it, but it does it on the not live. So I had to go in and put your names in and draw that way. So let's start off with our drawing winner from last week for commenting. So what's going to happen is when I want to do a drawing, it's going to have to be for the comments on my video after live. So if you could, once the video is over, or come back and make a comment, I will wait a few days, maybe 2, 3 days, or maybe the day before I go on live. I don't know. I'll figure that out. Probably the day before I go on live, I will do the drawing. But I can record it. So I did do that this time. And so I've been working on it. So let's just do that while everybody's hopping on. So this was my recorded one for who commented live last time. And I had to put the names in. So we're not going to do that next time. But this was my little video for all the comments from live last time. Hello, Jennifer, Heather, Lisa, welcome. So Barbara K, message me and get me your information. If you are in the US, I am going to send you the holiday rhinestones and the basic adhesive backed sequins. So those are the two that you'll be getting. My camera's in a different location, so it's kind of weird. Those are the two you'll be getting, so get me your information. Now, this one I figured out we could do live, but I need to minimize my program. It's a whole thing. It's a whole ordeal, you guys. All right, so this is for the people that joined my Facebook since the last video. So let's do a drawing here. I need to move my screen out of the way. Now you can't see, but I need to see who's going to win. And this one, you're going to get the holiday rhinestones. Oops, camera over here. Holiday rhinestones and all the trimmings embellishments. So if you are not in the US and you're a winner, I will mail you one of the cards from last week. All right, so here we go. So this one is live right now. So this one is the one that joined my Facebook page. All right, Lori Magnuson. So I'm going to write this down so I don't forget. Lori. Okay, Lori, contact me. Now, what I wanted to share is the way we can do the drawing is if I'm doing it wrong and somebody knows a better way, please let me know. But I use a third party. So that's my concern is being able to get that working on my other program. But when I choose you, when I'm going to choose you after and you sign on to my video when we're done and make a comment, I can click on your name and it'll give me your location and I can get a little more, like I can message you. So that'll be a lot easier too. Just in case you don't see the video, I want you to get your prize, okay? Welcome, welcome. Welcome, Karen. Okay, so a couple quick things. If you guys watch Frenchie, she had a comment today, this week. And hi, Melanie. Oh, I'm so happy you caught us on here. Hi, Chris. Linda, welcome. So Frenchie made, if you watch Frenchie at all or saw her post, she posted a little bit about casing cards and sharing cards. And a lot of people ask, can I case that? Can I share it? Sharon, welcome back. Hi, Olivia. Hi, Chris. So what I wanted to share a little bit about that, I know I mentioned it quickly going by, anything I ever create that I post online, pictures, videos, please, please copy it, share it, whatever. Courtesy is, I learned this from Marcie. I got this from Marcie. I saw this on her video, that kind of thing, just so more people can come over and check it out and see, how I created it and what I did. When I create, I try. If I know I'm going to create something and I say, oh, Lisa did this, I'll say, I saw Lisa do this, or I got this from Lisa. I don't always remember because, and I'm sure nobody always remembers, if you see something and you recreate it, if it's exactly the same, if it's super close, whatever, all you have to do is say, I saw a demonstrator do this. I saw somebody. It's just courtesy not to take credit. It's just, I see a lot of people commenting about it and saying stuff about it. And so I just want to put that out there. I never mind anybody copying my stuff. So. Yes, Heather, some people do ask you. And hopefully if they see my video, they know I do not mind, but that is courtesy, especially between demonstrators. Obviously, if you're not a demonstrator and you're just a crafter, you're not in the business. And so, I mean, you can do whatever you want. Everybody can do whatever they want. It's just a courtesy thing. That's all. But for me, you never have to ask permission to copy one of my projects. Please do. And if you need to know something that you can't see or have a question, just ask me. Okay, that business is out of the way. What else do I have? I'm gone next week. I do have two videos recorded for you, one for Tuesday, one for Sunday. And so those will be on here. And then I'm going to be working today and tomorrow on a project for when I return the first day. November 3rd, don't forget the Curvy Celebrations is available. Our DSP only a few days left. If there's a paper that you really like, if you have a stamp set that matches it, remember next year the paper's gone and new paper comes, which is great. But if you have that, let's say, whale stamp set, you probably want the paper. So you can create with that. Okay, one more thing. I am going to share a little video about the upcoming bloom box, and I'm not going to talk through it this time. My volume's off, so my computer's not dinging away. So last time I just rolled right over you guys and talked, and you didn't get to hear it. So I'm just going to play it really quick. It's like this long.
We've baked up something special for this November's paper pumpkin. Make the Christmas season a little sweeter with the Jolly Gingerbread Kit, filled with peppermint candy embellishments, curly rooftop designs, and as always, an exclusive stamp set that everyone will love. Subscribe by November 10th for a heartfelt holiday crafting experience.
So how cute was that? I love gingerbread. Welcome, Carol. Oh, Karen, you're welcome. All right. Okay, so we're going to get busy because I have a card we're going to create today. You might have seen it. It was my thank you card to my customers last month. I know, Heather, but you know what? I have so many Christmas cards done. I'm ready. That's going to be our paper pumpkin for next month in November. All right, everyone. So let's get busy. I think that was all of my announcements that I needed to make. Other than I did get my hair cut. Yay, I feel much better. Birds and branches. Okay, so I find myself doing flowers, butterflies, you know, cards like that a lot. And so I'm trying. Oh, you can see it right there. Oh, which way? Right there. That's the card we're doing, except we're changing up the sentiment. So, uh-oh, someone's at our door. No, it's okay. Okay, so this is the card we're going to create. So there's a lot of... Our doorbell just rang. I'm sure it's Amazon or something. Charlie, lay down. Okay, so that's Charlie. Okay, so here we are. We're going to make this. There's a lot of details. There's a couple little things I'm going to change. And so we're going to get busy because there's a lot to do, but I've done a little bit ahead, but we're just going to kind of show you as we go what we are changing up and what we're doing differently. So I have a pile of ink pads. So these are the colors. We're going to use all of those. Okay, so there we go. I'm going to take a screenshot, but as always, it'll be listed on my blog. Tashana, welcome. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is let me tell you what we're going to use. We're going to use our birds and branches, of course, with the dies. All right. We are going to use the palette thoughts, and I know you might not be able to see where that's being used, but we are going to use that. We are going to use our rectangle die, just the little one here for a sentiment. And we're going to use the waterfront. And you may not see that yet either. So we're going to do that. There's a lot of colors on here, right, Heather? All right, so let's get busy. I have our stamps taken out, so I'm just going to put these back away. They're all pulled out already. Okay, so we're just going to get going here. I already embossed this, so I'm going to save a little bit of time here for us. And that's our first panel here, which is 4x5 1/4, and that's in Pretty Peacock. This one is in Pool Party. Okay, then we have Early Espresso. All right, so it's going to be three, let's see, 3 5/8 by 3 7/8. All right, and then we're going to bring in our white, our Whisper White, and our vellum. Make sure you've got them going the right way. It's going to be the long way. Hi, Kathy, welcome. And what we're going to do is the vellum just softens up our image. This is our main image right here, but this is just softens it up because I don't want to just put a white piece of paper back there, right? So let me bring you in just a little bit. All right. So here is our card base. Here is our panel. Our Early Espresso. And here's our vellum. Again, the sizes will be on my blog. It's just about ready to go. When this video is over, I'll just link it up and we'll be ready to go. For this, we're going to take our Woodland Embossing folder and notice that the image at the top, you know what? I think this is, let me look. I have, let me look really quick. I want to make sure. Okay, so this is an old one I have, but we sell one. I thought this was Stampin' Up, but to be honest, I've had this for a long time, so I just didn't buy. You guys know I just came back to Stampin' Up in February. Anyway, you're going to pull out your Woodlands folder, and what you're going to do is you're going to have your little white piece of paper, and you're going to take your Smoky Slate. And what I do is you're going to, I feel which side is the background. This one is the background. Okay, this one is these raised up here are the trees. So you want to ink the background up. So we're going to ink this up. And just kind of find, make sure you get it big enough to put your paper in there. All right. And then you're going to take this and make sure you put your paper on the back side. You don't want to lay it on here because it's going to slide and get wet. But first, it does, Heather. And I've had this one for quite a while. So you want to make sure you take your like a baby wipe and curl it up the tightest you can around your finger. And this just kind of makes sure that you don't have any ink on your trees. I mean, you're going to have ink on the little branch parts, but you don't want to have big globs. And if you have a little bit, it's not that big of a deal. You're putting vellum on top of it anyway. I really wouldn't worry about it that much. Hi, Rio. Hi, Barbara. All right, so we're going to lay it on this side. Okay, just kind of figure out where you're going to put it. So I'm going to put it right about here. I just want to make sure it's all inked up. And I'm seeing a spot that's not, so just in case. All right, and so I'm fine with that. It's the idea of it, so you don't stress over it. All right, so you're going to lay it over here, and then you're going to just bring this part down, okay? And now you're going to run it through your embossing, your machine. And make sure you hold on to it so your paper doesn't slide around, because then it'll get all kind of weird and inky. And I'm going to pull it out. And then this is what you'll have. All right, so just be really careful. It's got ink all over my finger. I'm going to wipe down the folder just really quickly because I don't want... I don't like to leave the ink on it very long, even though it's water-based, I know, but I just like to wipe it off. All right. And make sure you wipe the other side off too, because where your paper was not at, you want to make sure you get it. All right. All right. So I'm just going to set that aside to dry. All right, so now we can just put those few pieces together and then set that aside. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to actually let it dry just a bit. So we're going to set this aside. And now let's get our coloring done. Let's do our branch first and our leaves. All right, so what I did is for the branch, so we are going to need the branch die, which is right here. We're going to need the branch die twice. That's what we're going to need right now. So what I'm going to do is take the palette. Oh, yeah, that's a fun one, Kathy. I'm going to take Early Espresso, and I'm just going to ink up my little palette piece here. This is the wood from the palette stamp set, the Palette Thoughts. And here I go again, just adding some texture. So we're just going to stamp right on this. I believe this is soft suede. Okay. All right. Now we're going to die cut this out. Okay, so all you're doing is adding some texture. So let's put that on there. Just make sure that there's some stamped image all over. All right, so there is our branch. And so you're just giving it some texture like a real branch. All right, so that's what we're gonna do there. Now what we're gonna do is take the green and we're gonna do the same thing, but we're just gonna cut this out. And you could have cut the other one out first. I think it's easier and faster just to do the whole piece. Oh no. Oh, good, Steph. Stephanie's working on a home project. Ooh, snowing. Ooh, no, it's beautiful here. The weather is so nice at night. It's crisp in the air and very, very nice. Okay, so there's your green. So I'm going to actually pull in a scrap piece of paper real quick, just so we keep our little work area clean for you guys to see. All right, so now what I did is I take the leaves with old olive. And this is what I did a little bit different here, is I used Mossy Meadow, and I think it's a little too dark. I just want it to be kind of light just to give it a little bit of interest. So we're just going to stamp on the leaves. And it doesn't have to be perfect. You see, I'm just randomly stamping. So see, you're just getting a little bit on all of the little leaves. Okay, that's it. All right. Now what we're going to do is bring our branch back in. And our scissors, and we're just going to cut our little leaves off. And then we're going to just dab the brown one just a little. And I like to take just little tweezers and then just get them on there. Make sure your stem's on, looking like a stem. Okay, so there we go. And then we're just gonna keep going. I did a lot of other stuff ahead of time. I didn't do this because this is kind of a technique. I just wanted to make sure you saw. And it just adds a little more. I mean, if you just did the brown and brown and the green and green, that's fine. It's going to give you your image. You could also maybe put the green through an embossing folder or even the brown and give it some texture that way. Like I said, I always try to think, okay, what else could make this card just a little different? And I just really like adding textures and depth to cards to just give it that little extra. And you're gonna put the flowers up on top of it and different things, so it's not like it's the main focus or anything, but I like the way it looks. All right, almost done. Okay. Now, I am going to try something on my screen here. Oops. All right, hold the phone. All right, I'm just trying a couple little things on my end just to make sure it's doing what I want it to do. So let me try this out here. Okay, we're just about done. You know, when you're doing something and you think, oh, this I could have done on this on video, or I could have done this ahead of time. Well, I did a lot of stuff ahead of time, but I chose not to do this just so I can kind of show you. Now this leaf, you can see it's part of the stem there. And so we're just gonna kind of cut it to make it look like a little branch. And it's a little rough right here. I just wanna curl it a little bit. There we go. And then we're just gonna add that. Now you can see where the little circles are. And that's where we're putting our flowers. So, oops. All right, I didn't really need this circle, so we're gonna cut that off. And it doesn't have to be perfect. Like I said, the flower is gonna go right on top of that. All right. So now, doesn't that look better? Give a little bit of a more realistic look to it. So there we go. All right. Uh-oh, my daughter's calling me. I think she forgets that. All right. There's another place I can see comments. That's what I was trying to look at right now, but okay, so we got our tree done. So now we're going to stamp our other images. So let's go here and we're going to do our nest. And so let me pull our card back in here a little bit. And we're gonna do soft suede. First, or no, we're gonna do crumb cake first. And then we're gonna take our soft suede with a dauber. And we're going to just kind of give it a little bit of a, some color around the outside. And just kind of give it a little bit, oops. And what I want to do is bring in my, my mat. All right, so there we go. So now we have our nest. So I have them all die cut and everything, but I want to show you kind of just how I did all this. Let me look. Hi, Nicole. Thanks, Carol. Yeah, it just kind of gives it a little bit more interest, a little more depth, and I like that. I'm wondering why it's hot in here, and I'm realizing my basket of stuff is right in front of my little fan. All right, so there's your nest. It's just adding a little bit of shading across the bottom, just so it kind of looks like you have a little more, you know, like it's shaded there, it's depth, whatever, so you can see that. So let's do that. And then we're going to do the eggs. So let me wipe this off and just move it aside out of our way. The eggs, I was so excited about this, and this is where the waterfront comes in. And these little speckles right here, I really like a lot. So I used these to make our little speckles in our eggs. So let me show you those. So we're going to use the pull party. And I'm just going to stamp it. Where's my scratch paper here? I'm rolling over it. It fell. All right. I'm going to see how dark. Okay. So I don't think we need to stamp off. So we're just going to stamp up here. Then we're going to take our little Sam pieces from the waterfront. And when you look at the waterfront and those types of stamp sets, they have a lot of little images in there that can be used for different things. Thanks for following me, Nicole. I appreciate that. So now we're going to take our pretty peacock and we're just going to make sure we get some good speckles on our eggs. Okay, so I can see on there that I have good speckles. And so add your egg. So now we have all those pretty little speckles on our eggs. Doesn't that look much better than just blue eggs? So if we just had our blue eggs, they would be like this. Now, it does give it some shading. It does give it a little more interest than just the blue eggs, but I really liked adding the little speckles on there. All right, so there we go. We have our eggs. And next, we did Don't Forget Your Little Bird's Feet. Now, when you look at the stamp set, let me grab the right color I need here. When you look at this stamp set, you're going to see, and the dies, you're going to see the little feet. There's two little feet right here. One bird's looking this way to the left, one bird is looking to the right, okay? So again, right here, you've got this bird and this bird. We're using this one because I wanted him off this side looking into the nest. So just remember, these feet are facing this way. And so it's basically like this. This bird over here belongs to those feet. This one belongs to this one. But then you've got the little feet too, like if you want them really sitting down. And I wanted our little guy like just sitting up on the edge of the nest. So keep that in mind when you do your feet. So we're going to do those in early espresso. Thanks, Norma. All right, so we're going to add our little feet. And let's do our bird while we have our early espresso out. So what I chose with the bird is we're going to do the outline in early espresso. So we're going to do our bird. I kind of want all the colors to tie. It's got that shading on those stamps. So when you think, oh no, early espresso is just way too dark, it really isn't. However, the pretty peacock, even though we are getting to a solid image, it still is like, well, here, I'll show you with it dark. Oh, I didn't stamp the whole thing. But see how the little belly is? It's not a full dark image. Okay, so you're going to get that shading in there, but we're going to stamp it off because I don't want the bird that dark. So let me pull in some scratch paper. Let me just fold this. Okay, so we're going to stamp off and we're going to do second generation. Here goes my head again. As always, we know I can't see. And just kind of get your little image right up there. And there you go. So I think he would have been way too dark had we not stamped him off. So kind of test it out. Have yourself a piece of paper and just kind of play with it and see what you're wanting. Maybe you do want it super bold and stuff, and that's fine too. But I wanted mine a little bit lighter. Okay, and so then for the flowers, what we did is I'm going to take my Mango Medley, which I love this color. I use it so much. All right, and then you're gonna take your flamingo, flirty flamingo. If you guys could share my video, I would so appreciate it. Thank you so much. It just really helps my station. And I'm trying to get to a number. It's my birthday month, so I'm like, okay, I want to really try and get my numbers up this month. And so the more you share, the more it helps my station. I really, really appreciate it. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to take the mango medley, and then I have a dauber with flamingo, and I just kind of go around the outside. Nothing. Okay, now here's another secret. Make sure when you stamp your image, you stamp them all going the same way. It's going to help you in the long run to, I put too much flirty on that one. It's going to help you in the long run to, when you're die cutting. Okay, so if you get them all going the right way, see, that's more of what I wanted. I put way too much of the flirty flamingo in the beginning. Another one of my favorite colors. So just barely go around the edges. Okay, so it just gives your flower, you're going to wipe it off in between because you don't want to contaminate your pad. Okay, and there's four flowers on the branch. You could add a fifth one, or you could have just done one down there, because I know that's an even number, but I think because it's so busy and there's one bird and three eggs, I think you're fine with doing four flowers. I'm not concerned about that. All right, so there's our eggs, our bird, our nest, our flowers, our feet, and I think that is all for this. But let's pull in our sentiment, which we're going to do happy birthday. So we need memento. Thank you, Deanie. I'm trying to recall mine at the same time, guys. Sorry. Hi, Sally. All right. So we have our sentiment, and I'm going to stamp it first, just the sentiment part. Okay. We're going to do the rest once it's already stamped, once we die cut the sentiment out. All right, so this is where our rectangle dies come in, and I really think I use these on every stamp set. Let's see, I think we went, I think this one, yep. So I am going to take a little bit of tape. I used my magnetic platform in my class, so I don't have it right here. That's okay. So for everyone that subscribes this month, or not this month, today, you will be going into a drawing. So I'm still going to do the old way that I did my drawings line, because I can go pull it off of my report on who subscribes today. So if you subscribe today, you will go into a drawing. And what will you get? Let me show you. It's something big. It's my birthday month, so I'm going to make it big. So let me show you really fast. If you guys don't have this, it is retired. It is gone. This was mine. I think it's used already, but I'm going to show you. Yes. You're going to get these. Let me see if I have any. Okay, so here's the envelopes, and here's the card bases. It's absolutely stunning. Okay, so that's what you're going to get. I mean, I don't even know if it says how many you get. Now what I did is I'm taking some DSP and I'm just putting it behind, you know, just adhesive it around the outsides and maybe a little bit in the inside or underneath your sentiment. And then you've got some beautiful note cards, and this would make a beautiful gift for somebody. So I've already got my pieces in here. This is for my envelopes, and the other ones are for my cards. And I've already made some changes in here and cut some stuff up. So you will get a full box of this if you are in the U.S. If you are not, I will send you one of the cards that I'm creating. Probably one of our Christmas ones. Okay, now we're done here. So don't forget to subscribe, like, share, all that good stuff. All right, we're done with our memento. I just feel like giving. It's my birthday month, why not? All right, so now we're gonna take our two colors again, our mango and our flirty flamingo. And we're gonna do the same thing. We're going to pick up our mango. We're just going to edge lightly and just kind of stamp a little image on the side. And don't forget, wipe it off. Pick up that. Do your little edges. All right. And you can see the two little centers are there, so that's a very perfect place to add your little rhinestones. All right, we're getting there. Now we just need to put some things together. Let me get this out of the way so I don't stick my arm in the ink. Okay, so now we have our sentiment. And with some magic, we have a nest, our bird, our flowers. Uh-oh, maybe I don't have my feet. Oh yeah, there's my feet. Okay, so let's put those together. Let's take our bird first. And I just like to add a little bit of glue on the ends. And you can set your bird as high or as low as you want, kind of. Position your feet underneath the bird, and then I turn it over and I just let that dry. All right, now I'm going to bring my foam piercing mat back in. So let's lay our flowers down. All right, let's move that. And now I just take I'm missing a flower, aren't I? Three. Oh, here it is. Four. All right, and then I just kind of go in the middle. It just breaks down the fibers a little bit. Again, adding a little more depth and texture. All right, now we're just going to set those aside. And now let's start putting our card together. All right, so first I'm going to put the vellum on our back piece there, and I have it overlapped just a little bit when I cut. This piece was just a little bit almost perfect to what I needed, and so I said, you know what, I'm gonna leave it like that. That way I can just trim it off and make sure that I don't go too small with it. I like to trim my white and my vellum at the same time so I know that they're the same. Now I'm gonna add my glue dots on the white branches. Okay, so I'm just going to add some glue dot on each corner. And then what I do is I'm going to take some runner, and then I'm just going to run it right about in the middle where the nest is going to go. Just so it sticks really well. And now I'm going to go in the corner. Okay, and just go like that. Then we're going to take the large scissors and go straight down. All right, there we go. So there's that. We're going to go ahead and add it here. It does have texture. It is an embossing folder. I'm going to do this just so it stays right away, but then I'll just take a little bit and put it in the middle just so we make sure it doesn't go anywhere. Your early espresso is going to be a tiny bit bigger. So just kind of get it on there. All right, so we have that done. Remember not to put your panel on your card right away because we want to add our ribbon. All right, so we're going to go ahead and add this on here. Because of the ribbon and the nest and the bird and everything, I did not use dimensionals on any of this. This is all glued on, okay? So we're just going to go ahead and glue this because this is going to get heavy once we start putting stuff on. And I want to make sure that the glue is going to hold everything on there. And this has, it's embossed. So I want to make sure. And I just kind of line it up on a line anywhere just so I can kind of get a reference of. A reference of where this is going to go. Now, is that upside down on birches where the branches go upward? It kind of looks like it is, but I like how, oh, my head was in the way again. Sorry, Chase. I like how you can see the little branches up though, but on birch trees, I think they go down. But we're going to cover that all up for the most part anyway, so I'm not too terribly concerned about it. But I'm thinking that they went the other way now that I'm looking at it. All right, so now we're going to put our nest on. All right, now remember your branch is going to go underneath that, so you don't want it too far at the bottom. All right, let me make sure I'm getting my comments here. All right. So what I'd like to do is take my branch. I just kind of like to lay it on there. And this probably could have gone up a little bit. I think I put it too low, but that's okay. Put my branch on there. And so just kind of eyeball where your nest is going to go. And now I take the little dimensionals and just add them. And then some I cut. That was a kind of a big branch and the rest really aren't that big. So I'm just going to add that and then I'm going to cut some. And if you look, if you go this way, they're all little going one way. But if you go this way, they're all like this. So just make sure you're cutting it the right way. I'm going to cut up to there. Because I can always use little dimensionals. And then just add them kind of one on each little branch just so it's a little secure. Make sure it doesn't go anywhere. And then I put one down here on the end, like right there. All right. And then I'm going to do one more, I think. Like right. Oh, I think I'm going to do it here because there's a flower going to be on top of that. So remember that. If it sticks out a little bit, your flower is going to be right on top of that anyway. Okay, so that's good, I think. All right, so we're going to take these off. Add it on. All right. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to add the ribbon first because I remember I took the branch up over. So with your ribbon, we're going to do the triple bow that I always like to do. And we're going to add a little thread on the inside too. It just kind of, to me, ties that earthy tone in. When you use the twine, it just kind of ties the earthiness of the card to me. All right, so we're going to take this. We want to make sure that it goes around the card. So lay it right here and make sure that this is going to go around the card. And then that's where you're going to hold this. Okay, and now I'm going to make a triple bow. 1, 2, 3. And then you want it to go around. So just make sure you pull it over enough to make your triple bow. So let's do that again. This is going to be hanging over, and now I want my triple bow. 1, 2, 3, and then go all the way over. And then come back through this right here. All right, and then you're going to let it go, and then you're going to have this beautiful bow. Okay, now just kind of get it twisted the way you want it. And now what I do is I take a glue dot. And we're going to put that right in the middle on the bottom. So right about there. And I'm not putting anything on yet because I want to tie my little bow. And what I'm going to do, oh, thanks. I'm going to double up my twine like this. And I'm going to cut it because I want it to be kind of a full. And we're just going to tie this around. So go underneath. And by gluing it, it just gives you that little bit extra support while you're tying this. Okay, we're going to tie it in a knot and then just make a bow. So now you're really making a triple or a double bow, but all you did is double up your thread. Oops, except let's try this again. There we go. And now we have a double bow. And now this is actually, the longer one is actually your little ones that hang down. See? So now you have your double bow here and here. We're going to fix this one once we glue it all down. And then you have your little tails on the brown, because you're not going to have tails on the pool party one. All right, so we'll fix that. We can make it a little smaller, a little bigger, whatever we want once we get it all together. I'm actually wanting one longer, one bigger, one smaller to just give it, again, you know, two loops, but not exactly the same size. Oh, Patty, you're so sweet. Thank you. Thank you, Mary. Thanks for sharing. I really appreciate that. All right. So now what I'm going to do is I always use white liner as soon as I can find it. So my tear and tape, take a little piece and just kind of go to the outside. You can just put your finger in the front and know where this is at. And then you're going to turn it over. Uh-oh, what happened to my... All right, and then same on this side, find that, and then just put that there. And now we're gonna take these off. Oh, look at that. I didn't burnish them down yet. All right, try this again. All right, then I try and make sure you burnish it so that it stays. And it's also on an embossed piece of paper, so that's not helpful. And so I just go kind of, you know, like half on, half off. I mean, I just cover the edges a little bit. Nothing crazy. Doesn't have to be exact. You're going to fluff that bow up. All right. So there's a lot of little detail. I'm going to just push the little bird feet on there and make sure they're stuck. All right. There's a lot of little detail once you get going. All right. And again, you know, I don't like to adhere it right away. And so I'm going to bring in my silicone mat because I do have my glue on the back. All right. We're going to just mess with this in a minute. I want to tighten my little bow up. And now let's bring our branch in. And so we are going to, let's see how I did this. You want it to where the nest is sitting on the branch, right? So we're just going to kind of and remember, you have another card base underneath, so it's okay that these are sticking up or out or whatever. This one is where the flower is going to go, so I'm going to pull that flower out. And so, oh, is my head annoying? Gosh darn it. All right, so I'm just going to kind of, you know, go up and underneath where you can. So it looks like your nest is really sitting in the branch, but you also want your little ribbon all fluffed. So I like to kind of do that. And then this branch here, I mean, it's really just a matter of kind of figuring out where your little twine's at, where your branch is, where you want it to go. You do have your foam, you know, your dimensionals on there, so you can have them in or out or around or whatever you want. I think I'm going to do this one under. This one under, so it's going to stick out kind of a little bit there. And then this one's over. It has a dimensional. It's really sticking to the ribbon, which I am perfectly okay with. And now let's do our flowers. Hi, Donna. I know our time zones are a little crazy between us. We either see each other really late at night or really in the early in the morning. Well, my morning, your night. All right, so here we go. So now we're going to stick our flowers right on those little circles. So there's one and there's two. Oops, stuck to my nail. All right, so there's two, and then we have three and four. There's one and there's one, and that's fine. We're going to make it work. It's all about where you're going to put your flowers. Luckily, our dimensionals stick like crazy, right? All right, so let's, there's one right here, and there's one down here. And you don't have to get them exactly on there, especially because the way we did our bow and everything, I'm not worried about that. You're going to see them just fine. Okay. Now we're going to do our sentiment. And we're just going to add, if you make your squares just go right on there, you're going to see that your dimensionals will fit just fine. And I like to put three. All right, we're going to just put that across the bottom. And like I said, I think we should have put this up just a tad, but that's all right. All right, we're just going to slide that in there. I'm going to move this onto paper lightly because I know we have adhesive on the back. Actually, I think that's centered fine. And now let's do our eggs. We're going to go ahead and glue two eggs. Okay, we're going to glue two of them. So there's one. I think I did this card, I want to say August, I think, for my thank you cards for my customers. I did a bunch of these. But I thought they were so pretty. Okay, this one we're actually going to pop up. So I have two in the background, and then I'm going to pop up this next one. And I'm going to put two mini dimensionals on it. And then I just kind of put it sideways, just kind of add that little character on that. And now we're going to add our dimensionals for our bird. Just getting done here. And I'm going to add one small one up on his tail. Nope, a half of one. I cut those other little ones in half right here. So I'm going to take one of those. And now we're going to put a little bit of glue on the feet. All right. And now we're just going to set this little guy up here. Oh, oops. Don't forget to take the covers off. I do that a lot. There we go. So we're just going to set him up there. All right, so there's our bird. We've got everything else going. Let's go ahead and adhere it now because we've just got a few little finishing touches. I'm going to use glue. It's not super heavy, but it does have some substance to it. So I like to use glue to make sure it's going to stay. Again, all the measurements will be on my blog. Don't forget to subscribe to go in the drawing. And what I did with the rhinestones is I actually wanted a dark color. And so, and I'm going to do it on the little ones. Let's see. This one was a little more yellow. I wanted a little more of an orange color. So I chose... This is the dark Cajun, and I wanted to just make them a little darker this time. And I just really liked how the darker looked. So it's all about preference. Just remember those alcohol markers that can really make a difference. Thank you, Norma. All right, so we're going to put that on there. Oops, I'm going to need one more. I already cut these here. Oops. Want to center them the best you can. All right, so there's that. And then let's, I need one more colored. We're going to do this one. I think I already cut that off. All right, we're going to add that one there. And I know the gems are odd number, I mean an even number, but I think sometimes when you're going with the odd thing,